So now I got the hammock strapped up with another one of the more simple ways to suspend your hammock, with webbing and cinch buckles. Real easy to use these to raise and lower your hammock. So here we're looking at the titanium cinch buckle right here, again, hooked to a continuous loop that goes to the end of my hammock. Now, if you order one of the modern hammocks, and you can often choose a suspension like a whoopee sling, or many of them have what they call webbing, which is this, and cinch buckle, which is that, this buckle and continuous loop will already be installed on your hammock. So you just simply sort of loosen that little bar, and this little metal bar in there is what locks down the webbing. And when I say lock down, you can see when I apply pressure to it, that bar right there is pressing down on that webbing quite firmly, and you don't need a knot. Now, you don't want to have it like this when you get in your hammock, because then you will get a slip. So always make sure that it's lined up. Just take a look at it, and it will hold for you. All right, we'll take a look at this one while I get in. I have never had one of these slip. And like my other suspensions, I have mine going up to a Dutch clip on my webbing, which goes all the way around my tree here. So it makes it simple to hook up and get your hammock ready to go. Very simple, very quick. But looking at this titanium buckle, and that next we'll look at the aluminum, which works the same way, other than the titanium has a notch and is always centered the way it's rigged to the continuous loop there. Now we're looking at two different cinch buckles right here by Dutch. This is the metal one, and you can see the way the Amsteel wraps around it. Okay, that is the less expensive one. This is the titanium one, and it goes to a V right there so that the continuous loop notches right in and keeps it straight. This one you have to adjust a little bit and keep an eye on it to keep it straight. The metal one with a continuous loop weighs 1.1 ounce or 31 grams. The titanium one with the continual or continuous, I never know which one to say, I say continual a lot, that weighs 0.5 ounce or 14 grams. This is a little simulation of, I just got to camp, I found my two trees, I've taken my hammock out, I've hooked my head end onto a tree, now I'm going down to a tree, and I'm gonna take my webbing, hook it around with my Dutch clip, pull my hammock up to where I want it, be about right there. Just take a peek at that just to make sure it's straight, and go ahead, give it a sit. It is a really fast suspension, and probably the most used suspension, because most hammock manufacturers offer that. A lot of them don't offer the descender rings. These days when you go, you'll get a choice of rope, cinch buckles, or whoopee slings for the most part. Okay, so I'm going back and we're looking at the Dutch clip there, which holds my webbing to the tree. I've slid it down the tree for this purpose. And like I say, we always want the webbing to go around and for the webbing to not come to the side and pull against the Dutch clip like that. Rather, come this way and not put that strain on the Dutch clip. It'll end up over a little bit like this always when you get in your hammock. But now we're gonna look at a little item that will replace the Dutch clip or a carabiner, and it's called a soft shackle. And what it is, it's got a stopper knot tied right there, and it has a loop right here that can pull out because it's spliced into itself here, and you can pull the whole thing out like this, slide that through. You got to kind of milk it closed a little bit. You want to make sure you do that. And it's just like a whoopee sling, you want to call kind of milky berry, which means rub your fingers around against this little berry until it tightens up on the knot like that. And that'll totally hold because I've used one on a webbing for years. So let's take a look at how it's going to replace that. And this is just another option. And the soft shackle is a really good substitute for you out there that don't like hardware, or you dislike rope, or you don't like any metal in your system. So, you know, if you're one of those people, and there are those people that don't want any metal at all, and I understand that, it's like I'm kind of funny about colors, you might want to use the soft shackle. All right, we'll just hang that right there. So we'll go ahead and take off the Dutch clip. Okay, and that's, like I say, the Dutch clip just has this little knob there and this hook here that keeps it on your webbing. I could take that off easily enough and replace it with the soft shackle. So I've got to kind of work my fingers right here and open it up a little bit to get the stopper knot out. That's the stopper knot right there. And then we're going to place that. The webbing right there, and you can use it the same way. It takes just a second longer, I think, but for some people, like I say, it's a really a preferred method. Milk it closed, good and closed. We'll get the knot right there so you can see it. We'll raise it back on up the tree. Now I'm just double checking that I can see that the stopper knot is closed up tight. And same thing, you want to do the exact same thing as you would on the Dutch clips. You don't want it pulling too hard off the side like this, because that's just going to stress it. And why do that? So you want to bring it around so it's right there and your webbing's coming through. Now I'll go ahead and get in the hammock. Got to tighten up my straps. Boom. And I'm in. And I'm out. So let's take it on down. I'm just going to slide it down just for filming purposes and get a better angle. And when you want to take it out, just kind of slip your stopper knot up. Open that up. Boom. Bang. Hook it back up just for next time, and you're done. All right, here we go. We're gonna weigh the titanium Dutch clip first. 8 grams, that is 0.3 ounces. Okay, we'll go back to grams, 8 grams. So now the soft shackle is 4 grams. 0.15 of an ounce. And the soft shackle can be purchased at whoopeeslings.com, and of course I'll put the link below in the description box in this video. Just another great hammock supplier, and one of the few guys I think that actually makes and supplies your soft shackle. All right, now we are looking at the aluminum cinch buckle. Now it doesn't have the notch like the other one. It has the Amsteel continuous loop that again goes to my hammock and my ridge line and goes out here. It adjusts the exact same way as the other one. It's just that the date right now is November, I think it's the 28th, 2017, and they sell for about $5 a pair, but check the website for that, and the titanium ones are around $22 a pair. And the most important thing to make sure of is when you hang this, that all of this wrap right here is squared away. That it's not all doubled up on each other like this, because then that will make your, well, if you, it does happen sometimes, like if you got it set like that, which then that makes your cinch buckle get a little cattywampus and it'll get off. And then I'm just pulling on it now and you can see it's sliding. So you wanna have that thing straight. Let's straighten it out. Most important thing to look out for on this is just making sure that your Amsteel is straight like that, the knots aren't overlapping, and that your webbing is straight. Other than that, it works exactly like the other one. So again, I'm just going to go ahead and get in the hammock and we can look at the whole thing with some pressure on it. There we go. Now you might notice that the Dutch clip looks a little different here. Same principle. It's that this is called a sewn in, and you can see it is sewn in to the webbing, and you have a little bit more space to hook it up right there. That's the sewn in Dutch clip. This is the one that you can take on and off and switch from webbing to webbing. It attaches to your webbing, held on with those two little barbs right there. This one is sewn, and you can also see the spacing's pretty close on this, so if you even want to save yourself just even a little bit more time, you have a bit more spacing on this one, and it just makes it even easier to hook your webbing through. Just make sure that it's behind that little barb when you hook it up on the tree. All right, and again, don't have it over to the side like this so it's pulling against itself. It just stresses the titanium and the stitching on the webbing and the webbing here. Make sure that it's over on the side of the tree like that. And that is the sewn-on Dutch clip. Okay, one last thought on these cinch buckles. A lot of people ask, well, why do I need to use a Dutch clip? Can't I just weave my webbing through the loop and not have anything on there? Yeah, you can, but with cinch buckles, every time you want to do that, you have to take the webbing out of the cinch buckle in order to do that. All right. Then you have your cinch buckle just like that. And when you do that, let's say it's not a Dutch clip up there, you've just hooked your webbing through the loop like I showed in the first part, you have to take the time to weave properly your webbing through your cinch buckle correctly. Frankly, I don't have that kind of time. So I'd rather use a carabiner or a soft shackle or a Dutch clip or something, particularly when I'm using the cinch buckle suspension. So we're gonna do one more cinch buckle suspension. It's actually called the Warbonnet buckle. It's like two triangles that go together and kind of overlap, similar to the descender ring, but enough of me trying to explain it. Let's go down there, take a look at it. All right, this is pretty specific to Warbonnet hammocks right here, and I have it on my Ridge Runner bridge hammock. But if you order a Warbonnet hammock with cinch buckles, either the Warbonnet Blackbird XLC or Traveler or the Ridge Runner, these are the kind you're gonna get. Now, a lot of people find them difficult to undo. Now, if you look at them, it's two triangles, right, that have the webbing between them, all right? And if your hammock's loaded with all of your stuff, yeah, sure, but one thing is to do that I like to do is just lift it up, put my fingers right there, all right? That loosens up the straps, and you can kind of take your finger in the back where I have it, kind of separate them, and that makes it a lot easier to slide it down. Pulling them up is not a problem, and one nice thing is they stay straight. I've never had them slip. You don't really need to put a half hitch behind them, a slippery half hitch, but if you wanted to, you could put a nice loose one like that and it won't get them out of line like a regular cinch buckle. So if I'm gonna loosen it up, again, I like to sort of push this up, take a little pressure off my hammock. I find these just easier to move if you kind of get them spread like that. You gotta get a little spread on them in order to loosen. Tighten, no problem. Again, sort of get your finger between them, get them spread out a bit, and sort of help feed your webbing through. Because they're tight. That thing will really stay tight. I'm gonna get in the hammock and let you take a look. One thing on any hammock, you're trying to adjust your suspension sometimes and you have your sleeping bag or your top quilt or your pad and your under quilt and your pillow and whatever you may have in there, your hammock can tend to get a little bit heavy, even heavier as the weather gets colder because you have more insulation. So a good trick is just to pull up on your hammock and reduce that stress on it, or just take that stuff out of the hammock if you're really having trouble. And there you have it, your Warbonnet buckles. So that's it. I wish there was more to show you on cinch buckles, but there's really not. That's about how simple it is. So finito, all done. We are complete. No more. We kimete kurasai. Arete, arete. I don't even know if that's a language. Because you know, I know everything there is to know about hammocks. I know nothing except that I like sleeping in them, laying in them, napping in them, and having breakfast from the hammock. That's all I know. That's all I know. Good times.